Authorities carry out an anti-blinker operation in several thoroughfares to identify motorists using the equipment. For more on this, we now have on the line ABS-CBN correspondent Jack Batallones. Jack?
Yes, Ron, the PNP Highway Patrol Group and the Land Transportation Office conducted an operation against civilian vehicles using unauthorized blinkers and sirens. The operation was held in three areas, namely Makati, Coastal Road, and Rojas Boulevard. A total of 19 vehicles were flagged down today for using blinkers and sirens. They were confiscated on the spot while the others were given the option to voluntarily surrender the apparatus. Violators were issued a ticket with a fine of 5,000 pesos. Based on the data from the Highway Patrol Group, since July 11, there are a total of 160 apprehensions nationwide, and 64 of them came from the National Capital Region. Based on Presidential Decree Number 96, the use of these devices is exclusive to the motor vehicles designated for official use by the AFP, PNP, LTO, NBI, BFP, and hospital ambulances. The PNP also warned sellers and auto shops from installing blinkers and sirens in private vehicles. Ron?
Jack Batallones with that story. Thanks, Jack. Philippine Budget Chief Amena Pangandaman says the administration does not have the final numbers yet on how many people and agencies will be affected in its move to right-size the government. She clarifies right-sizing does not necessarily mean the workforce of all departments will be reduced, as some employees may be trained and transferred to other departments. The government earlier proposed to determine which among the agencies and government-owned and controlled corporations may be streamlined through merging, restructuring, or abolition.
Si Presidente po, during our first cabinet meeting, nagbigay na po siya ng instructions po sa lahat ng cabinet members to already look into their specific departments po, kung ano yung mga pwedeng streamline. Yung nilalatag po namin ngayon na batas,
yeah,
is to give the president po the power to study po the democracy and then review po yung mga mandate and functions of the of our existing agencies po. So and then maybe po pag nabigyan po ang eksekutibo ng ganong powers po, we'll have a timeline po na kung ano po yung mga opisina na pwede pong matanggal.
Meanwhile, government workers group Courage strongly opposes the streamlining plan. It says the move serves the interest of local and foreign elites first over public interest. The group suggests the Marcos administration collect taxes more efficiently, curb corruption, and recover ill-gotten wealth instead of sacrificing government workers to have an efficient bureaucracy. President Marcos has designated Health Undersecretary Maria Rosario Vergere as the officer in charge of her agency. Press Secretary Trixie Cruz Angeles says the president is still reviewing his pick for health secretary. No word on how many candidates are being considered for that post. Angeles also noted they can just extend the period of service for designated OICs if there's still no DOH chief pick. Vergere is currently Undersecretary for Public Services as well as spokesperson of the DOH. In the meantime, the president has nominated former administrator of the light rail transit, Mel Robles, as general manager of the Philippine Charity Sweepstakes Office. Philippine state auditors flagged the transportation department for over a dozen incomplete projects. The Commission on Audit's 2021 audit report says the DOTR had 13 projects worth more than 8.6 billion pesos that were either delayed, terminated, or suspended for various reasons. The COA says these delays have deprived commuters of a more comfortable transportation system. The DOTR has assured COA it is already catching up on those projects.